I'm also thankful to the leaders of the church. For them, they wanted for me to stand before you. I've been given this license to stand before you today. For I am the one that is closing this year. I am the one that is closing the door of the year. I am now standing for all them that preach before me. Then before taking time, I'm also thankful to you. You left your houses. You know the cold that is outside. It's not for anyone to come out. People are staying in the blankets. And others are staying close to the TVs. You left everything to come and hear the
word.
And as well as I say for the God, and I'm also making God bless you. And without taking time, we have remind one another what happened last week. Because last week we were here.
Tulifundishwa.
We were taught.
Lakini wengine hawakukua.
But others were not here.
Tunaweza kanyuleta kadogo.
Can we remind them what we were taught?
Kwa ile ilipita Jumatano.
For what was taught last week.
Kwa kwa tulikuwa na mchakazi wa Mungu tena.
Because we had a woman of God.
Alitufundisha vizuri sana.
Who taught us a very good thing.
Ninajua wenye walikuwa walibarikiwa.
I know for those that were here they were
blessed. Hata na mimi nilibarikiwa.
And I was also blessed among them.
Kwa kweli siku alituambia ni siku ya mtoto kuzaliwa.
Especially he taught us about the day Jesus was born.
She bought it to the Sherekele Siku.
We all celebrated that day.
And
the whole world because it was the birth of Jesus Christ. And she told us that. The child was born. It was not a normal child like others. It was a different child. Because it was not a child that came from one family. Did not come from one tribe. Came for everyone. Was born in every house. In every tribe. In every country. Everybody celebrated for
him.
It's a child that was different. Because the old child, just as like just as was born in the family. Then they sent them and got a new child.
He
was born in the family of Amuli.
But Jesus Christ
was born for everybody, for the whole world. Because was a child because the child has the
strength.
They read in the book of Isaiah from verse 6.
You
can take the verse and go and read it. It's going to help you. So that you can also see that you were here. You will also see that you were here with us.
You
told this child was a powerful child. A child that will bring peace. And also us today. We continue to celebrate. We celebrate. We continue to be here. Because the child has already arrived. Has already arrived in the house. It's us, up to us now. To carry the child. If you are given the child, you must have You must be with him. Because he was in the womb for 9 months. But to get to 18 years old, it's not easy. And that is the hard work. That's the hard work. And for us here, we have received the child. And we must continue to raise the child. To raise our child. To be shown that you have received that child. Amen. So without taking time, because our time is very short, we're going to hear
the word.
Because the word. The word of God is always new. There's no word that is old, it's late. But every word from God is good, and it's very good, and it's very peaceful.
Amen.
Amen. And they heard the
child
because you have received the child. But today the child is asking, what should I do for you?
what should I do for you? So without any time, we first going to read in the
book.
We're going to read in Marco, verse
36
to 52. Brother Andrew, can you read for us?
Marco
10.
Tusome kitabu cha Injili ya Marko sura yake ya 10 mstari wake wa 46. Nasema hivi: wakafika Yeriko. Hata alipokuwa akishika njia kutoka Yeriko pamoja na wanafunzi wake na mkutano mkubwa, mwana wa Timayo, Bartimayo, yule mwombaji kipofu, alikuwa ameketi kando ya njia. Na 17, naye aliposikia ya kwamba Yesu wa Nazareti, alianza kupaza sauti yake na kusema, mwana wa Daudi, Yesu ni rehemu. Na 18, na wengine wakakemea ili anyamaze, lakini alizidi kupaza sauti, mwana wa Daudi, unirehemu. Na 19, Yesu akasimama akasema, mwite. Wakamuita yule kipofu, wakamwambia, jipe moyo, inuka. Akaita. 15, akatupa vazi lake, akaruka, akamwendea Yesu.
Watu wasikia habari ya kipofu.
We know when you hear the
iko habari inaitwa nzito sana.
It's a very tough.
Juu wakati uko kipofu.
Because when you're blind,
hauna cha kujifanyia.
You have nothing to do for
yourself. Na huyo kipofu Bartimayo, hakuwa na kitu ya kujifanyia.
Have nothing to do.
Ni kumtosha mnyumbani,
kumpeleka
katika barabara.
And put him on the road.
Pale anafika pale ni kulomba.
And when he gets there, to
analomba. Kila mwanapita anampatia yale
yenye
mwenye
anapenda atakusalimu.
Mwenye anapenda hata mwangalia
hapo. Some people will not even look at
him. Mwenye kuna kitipa atamupa.
For one that has money.
Mwenye kuna pesa atamupa.
For one that has money.
Lakini kwa huruma kubwa aone kama ile kitike na hivyo wala
haivi. But he won't know if the banana is good or not.
Wanaweza kumpatia pesa.
They might give him money.
Lakini ile pesa ajue tena inauzaka wala haiuzaki.
He won't know if the money is
good. Ile yote ataikamata tu.
All that is just taken.
Lakini alikaa pale njiani.
But he was on the road.
Lakini neema ya Mungu ikakuja kwake.
The grace of God came to him.
Akasikia sauti.
And he heard a voice.
Akasikia sauti kubwa.
He heard a voice.
Akasikia fujo.
He heard a good big
crowd. Lakini hakuikaa.
He did not sit.
Akauliza.
And asked.
Ni wanani wale?
Who are those?
Kule kuko nini?
What is happening?
Lakini wakamwambia.
And they told him.
Ni ule Yesu Mnazareti iko na pita.
Jesus Christ that is passing.
Ule Yesu Mnazareti ndio ule mwenye biko na shangilia.
Jesus Christ to whom they make it noise for.
Akasema ya kwamba.
And he said.
Moyoni mwake akasema sitawakia nabii hivi.
And in his heart to say.
Inakuwa nabii.
Ni
muone ule Yesu Mnazareti.
This is Jesus Christ of
Nazareth. Hata basi ni mpapase hata na mikono wakati
wanaona. By the hands. And he raises his voice. He didn't know how to stand. Just to stand and see. And he started raising his voice. And he said, Jesus of Nazareth, please have mercy on me.
Alisema mara mingi juu
kwenye watu
wanaanza pia mzuia.
Because when people are stopping him,
akusema baba, akusema mara moja.
He did not say only once.
Maana alipaza sauti.
That meant he has raised his voice.
Yesu Nazareth unirehemu.
Jesus of Nazareth.
Yesu Nazareth
unirehemu.
Yesu Nazareth unirehemu.
Jesus of Nazareth have mercy.
Lakini watu wakakuja kumzuia wakamwambia.
But people were stopping him.
Unauzi mwalimu.
You are disturbing.
Wewe ukae.
Just sit down.
Kipofu auone.
You are blind. You can't see.
Wakamdharau wengine waenda
people even pushing him.
Juu kwenye kuko watu wengi.
Because when they said not to the people.
Pale kukukosa mabayuwa mingi.
I'm sure there was a lot of people. I'm sure some people were just.
Lakini yeye hakunyamaza.
He did not stop.
Hakunyamaza.
He did not stop.
Alisema ya kwamba mpaka na mie tu
akiema.
Akaendelea. Akaendelea. Na Yesu akaona imani yake.
Jinsi
alikuwa anategemea.
The way that is on him.
Mpaka
until he sees him,
akageuka nyuma.
And Jesus turned back.
Yesu aliona wale wengine wote.
Jesus saw others.
Lakini hakubageukia.
But he did not turn for
him.
kumuita.
Why? Because they did not come.
But
he got the dasis.
Because
of the courage he
had.
So by his faith to call upon the child of
man.
And Jesus turned and asked, who is this that is calling
him? And they told him,
he's just a blind man.
Then
he said, just sit
there. Mungu, alimuita kwa tofauti, alimuita na sauti ya
kitofauti. And the first time is not normal.
Yes, wakasema.
And Jesus said, no.
Mwende mumuchukue. Mwende mumuite.
Bring him to
mwende mumuite.
Call him.
Wakakuya, wanaelekea.
They were all
waiting.
Because they were discouraged. He found himself that he can't even step. And he said, no. Let me take all this. And he took off his jacket. The jacket was full. All the food. All the food they have given him. All the food they have given him every day. He was just keeping in his jacket. And he found himself alive. And he said, for me to go
quickly,
let me take the jacket off.
And
when I take the jacket off, I'll be quick, I'll get
everything.
He took the jacket off. And then he went. When he got there, before the teacher, told the teacher, the teacher asked him, what should I do for you? He didn't ask for money. He had a big request that needed for him to get all that
money.
And he told teacher, I want to see. And the teacher told him,
imani yako inakuponya.
And then he saw. And he was able to see. And then he followed
Jesus.
Because he had already seen. And you do today. We are getting in 2018. God is asking
you.
God is asking you today. What should he do for you? Are you going to ask for
houses?
Are you going to ask for cars? All is up to you because he's a king. Because he's a king of all for king. Are you going to ask for power? Because you know 2017. You worked quickly. You were weak. Ask God now. Now that you're asking me what
Give me more strength.
Than what I did in 2017. and the jacket. And the jacket you have, take it off. Because if you have the same jacket in this 2017, you won't be able to go in
2017.
The jacket will make you heavy.
But
God is there.
To answer
your request for this 2018. Because He's given us a good word. He's telling you today, what should I do for you? We have this grace because God is going to do for you in 2018. Whatever you're going to ask for God, He's going to do it for you. If you want a car of 2018, God will give you. You won't be driving the old cars all the time. If you say my gift to go over and over, it's going to go over and over.
And here our grace will
say, if we hear our grace will say, God has called us. Here our grace, what should we do before we get to us? I'm sure there's some of us who ask, oh, God, give us a lot of people to fill the whole church, to go over at the top there. As I can see from the way I'm looking at it, and I see that's the Jesus in God's prayer. That's what Jesus said. What should I do for you, people of grace? I'm sure some of us are asking, in 2019, we should be all the way to the end. That is our biggest. That is our biggest request. Because of God, and we believe. If we say that, then He's going to do it. He's going to do it. He's going to do it. Because there's a lot of pagan outside. There's a lot of pagan outside. There are those that have already rejected the cross. But if we want them to come, they will come. And they will sing in this
place.
And they are going to preach in this place. And they're going to do all the work of this church. And I'm sure that we will have sponsors of this church. All those people are outside there.
But
we must get to God. Today, in this year that we have started, give us the strength that you have, that your mighty power to do.
Because
when the preacher stands, the worshippers should worship in spirit. For those that pray in strength, and I'm sure God will do it. And God will do it. And God is going to do it with us. He's not going to leave us. Because the Bible says that. For those that ask me, they're not going to stay behind. You're not going to be a prayer will be there. But today, God is asking us. He's asking you, What should I do for you?
Ile shida yote ulikuwa na 2016.
All the problem you had in 2017.
Yote.
All of that.
Umwambie Mungu.
Tell God.
Sitaki tena hii.
I want to go forward.
Kama asira ilikuwa na kufunga sana.
If it's the stress.
Uko ile kote ya asira.
If it's the anger. Take the anger of anger out. And go to God.
Umwambie nipatie furaha sasa.
Tell God, give me the
joy. Tupo ni asira iko.
Because where the anger
is. Furaha inakimbia.
They have the joy is. We have
stress
and sorrow. So God, what do you want to say for God? Take this sorrow. It's going to be very
powerful.
If they give you the joy, it's very big. It's very big. The houses and everything is going to be very big. It's very big. The joy is
God.
If you are
joyful,
you will have put
God
joy. Because if you are joyful, even if I have the 15th voice, I will sing because I'm joyful. And you can be filled with the Spirit. But tell God. Help me to take off this jacket that I have on me, to go to you, to run to you, God of peace, God of blessings, God of living people out. To listen to him. If everything has been locked you down, everything has been locked you down this year, leave it behind and tell me what you're telling me. I'm telling you what you need. And I'm also telling you all the sickness to leave me. All everything that is hindering me. All this talking, the way I talk too much, leave me alone. I know there's others, if they don't lie, Because before, he was the biggest liar of all, but today, he has really come back. He had the anger. It is anger. He's going to tell you, and it's together we're going to meet. Even though to God's house you're not going to reach there, but that's just going to be speech. But today, this person has already changed. This person is not asking forgiveness. Brother, forgive me, brother. That people are going to be, they're going to be surprised. And they will say, where has that grace when he goes? He has found God at grace. The grace that he has going to, he has found God. He has changed. And others will follow him. They will follow you without you telling them. Because they will see you have left the jacket. You left the jacket behind. The jacket that was broken. The jacket that the people were laughing at. Because when you have that jacket, you are heavy. Everybody just looks at you, down on you. Because the jacket itself is smelling, because it's full of food. But when they found you have left the jacket, everybody will come close to you. Everybody will meet you on Golden Eagles. This year is our year of blessings. This year is our year of peace. This year is our year of because God is saying what he do for us. What can he do for us? Because you do, even you ask yourself. Even if Chudo comes here, Chudo ask you, what should I do for you? Imagine. You will be confused. Now, God of all that is asking you. The one that has everything. You ask the person that knows everything. The one that has everything. You're going to be very thankful. Don't give him some small requests. Because if that brand new apple, I want to eat. Do you think the eyes would have been open? No. God would have given food. Because his food, he wanted. If he wanted money, yes, you would have given money. But his food. If I ask for money, the money is not going to do anything. Because the money itself, I'm not going to see it. Others will eat it. If I ask for food, others will eat it. But let me tell you, then I want to see. That when you see, Let's ask for God to give us the strength to give us the power to work for him. And that is open all the doors. That's going to open the money request, the good
morning,
everything will go, the sickness will go, everything will go because you have God. Walk with him. Tell God to hold you. All this ordeal of 2018 to be walking with you. Do not leave you sick. Do not leave your
home.
Don't leave the child to stay in the house. Tell the child to show the child the all the lights, all the playful ground. And that's why
God has
given us this word today to help us in this year that we start. In this year, we're going to start to be a night. So they won't go like the person, the people of last year. Because all of the things that we have done in 2018, all of the things we have done in 2018, we have forgotten. And we want to start a new
one.
If you know you, tell the person, my sister, my brother, we have started new. 2017 is gone. This is 2018 now. Because God is telling us, wherever that we want to ask, He is asking us what is going to do for us. And He says, it's good. Because we can see the hand of God. Because maybe sometimes the brother sees you and the person cannot talk to him. But he is open. And it's going to be
open.
And the God is going to be done. In 2018, let's tell God for everything that is going to be done. Everything. Everything that we have done in 2018. To forgive us. To forgive us. To be shown in our lives. New. To work in peace. In peace and in love. Because the Bible says only two or three and you are all held together in love. You're going to do something very big. Something very big that is even more than 50 people that are not together. And that is why today I'm so thankful to God for this word that God has given us. He's telling us what He wants for us. We want Him to give us. Everyone has a request. Everyone has a request. And everybody should take the request and give to God. God, do this for me. If you don't have your word, tell God give me one. You might have a work because it's worthless, but it's $10 or $12. Tell God, this work is not the work I'm looking for. Give me the work of $20 on your child. And God is going to give
me.
Because He said, what should He do for us? He is the one that is asking us today. Let's tell God. If it's sickness that is up to you, tell also that God. And He's going to give you the healing. He's going to give you the healing. And He's going to heal you. And He's going to see the blessings of God. If you're lazy at His work, also tell Him to give you the strength so that you might work in the truth. Not to work but why you hurt, like someone that's been held behind. Or to be using the excuse of we're not too many, God is not of the multitude. God says two or three. It's not one of that. Here we are too many. But in God, but to God is not going to say until you are hundreds and hundreds of people. Even if you go in your room and tell God today, you have taught us, you are asking us what you are going to do for us. Tell God tonight, today, this year, I want brain to school. I want a good brain. He's going to give you that. He's not a God that says and then goes back in His words. The same way he's asking you. The same way that he asked the blind man, what should I do for you? And but he said, the blind man said, I want to see. And he was able to see. Instantly, he was able to see. And also today, the one that God is saying, he's going
to do it.
The one that he's going to answer, the one that you're going to ask, if you want to ask for the money, it's the money that's going to give you. He's going to give you. If you want the gift of God, he's going to give you that gift. If it's the strength, he's going to give you that. And that is what we
need.
It's a very joyful day. It's not going to come again in our life. Here now we are very
humble.
Today night, we are saying bye-bye. 2017, we're never
going to
see it again. We have started new things, and our lives will be new, and let's continue. Let's not take the jacket, the heavy jacket in 2018. Let's throw it away and go into
2018.
Let's know that we're going to the end. Last week to our
prayers.
Let's not be happy at the end of the year because we are
living ourselves.
Because the way the year is finishing, you're also living yourself to your
end.
If they have told you you're going to be 40 years, now you know it's 39 only years left. And that is why the most important thing. Let's pray to God. We, the children of God, to give us the strength to
work for him.
To give us the strength to do his work. Because it's only the powerful that will take the kingdom of God. Don't think the laziness will take the kingdom of God. Today, I'm so thankful. And I'm so thankful also because I believe this word. Yes, that is children. And his children. They will change. And his children. We're going to be seen. We're going to be new in this coming year. This word should be said to you and also to me. In Jesus Christ. Amen.